Milwaukee live at St. John Arena in Columbus, Ohio, where the Buckeyes again take dead aim at a Big Ten championship and a possible number one seed. Meanwhile, the Purdue Boilermakers must regroup if they have any hope at all of getting back to the big show. Good afternoon. Welcome, everybody. Along with Jim Valvano, I'm Brent Musburger. Nice to have you with us on this Sunday afternoon. Jimmy, the Buckeyes ran off 17 straight and finally lost for the first time this
week. They lost their first game, Brent, really for two reasons. Number one, they played on the road. And any conference is tough on the road, especially in the Big Ten. They caught a Michigan State team that's up and down. They caught them up, hence the loss. But number two, and more importantly, it's not so much where you play, it's not so much who you play, it's how you play. And it was an atypical game for the Buckeyes. You see their field goal percentage down, their rebound margin down, assists down, and the opponent's shooting percentage up. Hey, you're on the road, you don't play well, you're going to get a loss. But they'll play well today in St. John.
Gene Cady against Randy Ayers, the two head coaches. And that brings us to another story. Let's go to Mark Jones. Mark?
That's right, guys. You know, Gene Cady will be the head coach of the U.S. team at the Pan Am Games this summer in Havana, Cuba. Now, ironically, one of his assistant coaches will be the guy he's coaching against today, Randy Ayers, although that hasn't been officially announced yet. Now, Cady was speaking with us yesterday at practice, kind of in a good mood, joking around, saying he might reconsider taking Ayers to Cuba if he whips him on television today. They won't be kidding around, though, later. When we come back with a tip-off, it'll be the Buckeyes and the Boilermakers busting the move right here on ABC.
ABC's College Basketball. Brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Budweiser, the king of beers, with that clean, crisp, cold taste. Nothing beats a Bud. And by Catapult, with the anti-fatigue rebound mechanism that you can actually feel from LA Gear.
Ohio State 17-1, and the same five players have started in all 18 games for them. For the struggling Boilermakers, 11-7 on the season, a couple of key changes today. Travis Trice will start at point guard, and Ian Standback, a freshman from East St. Louis, will move into that front line. Chucky White, number 23, shifts over to center. The storyline today, Jimmy.
Well, for Purdue to have a chance today, they really have to be concerned with tempo, tempo, and more tempo. Run when they want to, but slow it down. And secondly, their guards, who are shooting below 40%, have to shoot well. Ohio State, they want to get an early lead and try to put away the Boilermakers early. And secondly, watch them pressure the guards of Purdue, because Purdue's starting two freshman guards. Watch that press for Ohio State.
The Boilermakers have been a slow-starting team this season under Gene Cady, but he had them out early today. An early morning practice, and he drove them, and that's putting it nicely. There will be taking no prisoners with this defense here this afternoon, and they'll be trying to jump ahead and get some action going early. The Buckeyes in their home whites. St. John's standing room only. Long tap controlled by Baker. Mark Baker, the best point man in the Big Ten, tries to get it deep with the first pass. And it goes over to the Boilermakers.
And Brent, they start the press immediately.
Darner 30, the off guard. He's double teamed against the trap in the corner. Gets it back into the middle, and White will help out deep. Now Oliver. He will draw Jackson. Jackson will track him all the way in this game. That's the key matchup to watch as far as Purdue is concerned. They need a go-to guy desperately, and they want to get Oliver involved if they can. Taking time off the clock, Purdue obviously wanting this game down in the 60s. They're not going to attack early. They do not want to get into an up-and-down offensive game.
Great, they were running the weave. We haven't seen that for a long time in basketball. Michigan State's the only other team I know that weaves.
Watch the shot clock. They'll get it down to five, and they'll pull the trigger underneath. Good defense by the Buckeyes. They come down now with a set. Baker in the middle. Here's Brown. He's a good shooting guard. Lee, the forward, steps outside for the game's first field goal. Trigg Lee, underrated player. Now that pressure defense that Jimmy V told you about. All over the ball. Woody Austin, as Boilermaker fans know, academically ineligible. They've not been the same in the backcourt, so Ohio State trying to apply some pressure early on the guards. The This is Trice, the point man, positioning the offense, taking his time. Patience, the key for the Boilermakers. Remember, it takes him a minute and a half on the average to just get on the scoreboard. Bringing it back out now. Bringing that shot clock down underneath 10 seconds. Inside to White. It was easy. They pounded the glass.
That's exactly their game plan. Utilize the clock and then get the ball inside.
Fast break to Brown for the layup, and the Buckeyes have got the lead like that. Trying to force an up-tempo game. Get the score up into the 80s and 90s. The trap in the corner, and a foul call against Ohio State. The Big Ten standings will show you that Ohio State is tied with Indiana. But a key factor to keep in mind, both Indiana and Michigan State must come through St. John Arena to play. That makes the Buckeyes the favorite. Now, why is it important to win the Big Ten Conference? First of all, they do not play a tournament. But secondly, you probably will wind up undoubtedly with the number one seed in the NCAA tournament. The key for any team in the field this year is avoid Las Vegas. Stay out of their region.
Remember something, though. Last year, Ohio State gave Vegas a great game in the tournament.
Like I said, Jimmy, stay out of Vegas' region.
You see, one of the problems Purdue is a lack of outside shooting. So when you do wind the clock down, they've got to go inside, and those guys are going to be doubled. Somebody's got to step forward and shoot well from the perimeter.
Trying to get the steal, ball preserved. There's the three, and it is Oliver who hits it from the perimeter.
Thank you very much. But then on the other side, Ohio State really needs to guard Oliver because he is their best perimeter shooter. Let their guards shoot.
He stepped out of bounds. Jackson was coming down the baseline. There he is, number 22, a splendid all-around basketball player, Jim Jackson. Starts at small forward. He can also handle the ball, and the first substitute is made by Randy Ayers, and he will sit his point man down and talk to him about something that he has seen out on the floor. And in his place, Jamie Skelton, the freshman from Dayton, Ohio, Meadowdale, on the floor for the Buckeyes. Ohio State favored in this one by 15. It was like he was following an offensive tackle, and a screen set out high, and this time they've got him. That's Chucky White, the first foul. He got away with the first one, but not the second one.
I'm not sure about that. Gene Katie didn't like it. Is the man set? Oh, he's set. That, in my opinion, as long as you give time and some vision, and he did both those things, I think that call was not a proper one.
The crowd helped make that call, and Katie will be on his feet and on fire in this one. He'll be driving the Boilermakers. If they are to get into the NCAA, they must have a win here at St. John Arena or next week in Bloomington, Indiana. And moving in is Jackson and commits the personal foul.
Makeup. Could be a little makeup. I'm not so sure that was over the back either. Oh, Gene Katie. Look at that. Will you look at that jaw? Oh, that man is something. Is he intense or what? Practice today was certainly not for the weak of heart. I'll tell you, he went after him today. And there's the turnover, Brett, with the pressure. They had the game. Purdue did the way they want. The tempo, they had it their way. They hadn't turned it over against the press. They don't want to come from behind. They'd like to stay somewhat, if they can, somewhere in the lead or a bucket or two difference.
Purdue 5, Ohio State 4. Trey Lee steps out high. You can see him there in the middle without the ball. Skelton, the point man. And now Brown handling. Brown is number 30, Jamal Brown, a junior.
Now they've got Purdue. There's the tempo they want. Ohio State taking their time.
Lee is 2 for 2. Steps back outside and immediately helps out with the trap. And they force the turnover. Jackson to the inside. Skelton is well defended. And the ball goes out of bounds. Ohio State's possession. How about Purdue's problems in the backcourt?
Well, they've got the freshman. Look at the shooting percentages. I mean, 25% for Trice, and he started today, and they total. They don't total about 12 points, and they turned it over the last two times down against the pressure.
And on that stoppage, Baker, number 3, returns to the lineup of the Buckeyes, handles the ball. Jackson missing. Did not shoot well against Michigan State the other night. Purdue's possession, trailing it by a point, 6-5. Now the patience of the Boilermaker attack. Here's Trice giving a little quickness in that backcourt, operating at the point. A lot of pressure on the youngster. You'll have to set the tempo. Stand back, another freshman. There are 3 freshmen in the Boilermakers starting lineup here today. That's how young and inexperienced they are. Trice on the penetration, has it deflected off the glass, and a putback by number 34, Stand back.
The longer Purdue stays in it, you know, the tougher they become. They're doing a great job with their game plan. Milk the clock and go inside.
Purdue hoping to hang in the neighborhood and then get a better finish than they've had this year. Jackson off now to Carter, goes to the glass. Perry Carter puts down his first field goal. Seesawing, ball knocked out of bounds. That pressure defense is causing problems for Purdue in the backcourt. Gene Cady is going to have to figure out a way to have Trice and the rest of this offense get the ball up against that pressure. We've got a timeout in Columbus. Will this be upset Sunday? Already DePaul has picked off Georgetown, and here Purdue has put 7 points on the board in the first 5 minutes. Jimmy, talk about coming up against a pressure defense.
Well, you've got to go over the top. Right now, Purdue is throwing the ball exactly where Ohio State wants it. Abe Lemons at a clinic once asked, how do you beat the press? He said, listen to the other coach. They said, what do you mean? He said, the other coach is always yelling, trap him in the corners, trap him in the corners. So I tell my guys, don't go in the corners. And I'll tell you, it's very valid. Get it out of the corners. You got to keep it in the middle of the floor or over the top. Purdue is not doing that.
And Purdue scrambles to get it up this time. They had two efforts. And the possession arrow now moves back in favor of Ohio State after that jump ball situation. That's why Purdue got a second chance here.
And if this game stays close this way, look for Ohio State to do some trapping on the half court. You can't let Purdue milk the clock and then score inside. They milk it for 25 seconds, and then they go inside.
Well, there is White, number 23, Chucky White, out of Monrovia, California. One of the seniors, Dave Barrett, senior guard out of Lafayette, Indiana, will move in. And number three, Travis Trice, sits back down. Barrett had been the starter at the point.
You know, Brent, both you and I really like this Ohio State team. We had them earlier. We've seen them improve. They've got that great balance inside, outside, bench strength. And that's when you look at a team, you say over the 40 minutes, Purdue doesn't have that. It's going to be difficult if their guards don't shoot. They turn it over. Hard to stay with the Buckeyes without an inside-outside game.
So traveling, and Gene Cady's team has turned it over for the fourth time here in the first 5.5 minutes of this game. It is 8-7, Ohio State with a lead. The winner of the Big Ten undoubtedly is going to wind up with the number one seed. Buckeye fans would like to play in the neighborhood. Carter looking for a receiver, ships back to Jackson. So far, it has not been easy for Ohio State. Treg Lee has done the heavy part. That's 3 of 3 from the perimeter for number 34. Running the baseline, which is legal after the made field goal. Buckeyes are up by 3. When you're slowing down, you do not want to fall behind by too many points here in the early going. Very important for the Boilermakers to get a good shot.
Next 4 minutes are critical here. If they fall down too much, they can't come back.
Well, Oliver has hit 1-3 in the game. Painter is also on the floor. That's Matt Painter, number 12. He had checked in off Katie's bench. They've been bringing the shot clock down inside of 10 seconds before they begin their assault. White along the baseline and Lee off with the miss. Lead pass. Jackson gets it back. His first field goal.
Gene Cady knows he's in trouble, and everybody's shooting pretty well right now, especially Trent Lee.
Knocked out from behind. Purdue ball.
So what a great coaching move, Randy Ayers, before the season, starting Trent Lee, right, who really hasn't fulfilled his potential, and bringing Chris Gent, as we speak, off the bench, one of the best 6 men in college basketball.
Randy Ayers, who has done a spectacular job with his Buckeye team. Second year as the head coach. And Oliver now has hit his second 3. So they've got their go-to guy on the outside. Now they need a Mr. Inside to team up with him.
And Randy is talking to his team, saying, don't let that guy shoot. Anybody else can shoot for Purdue, but don't let Oliver shoot, and he buries another one.
Purdue has been tough defensively, but the Buckeyes working away. That was Robinson drawing the foul, and he'll step up to the free throw line. He'll shoot a pair, and that is 2 on White.
Anytime you get penetration against any defense, it's going to cause a problem. Jimmy Jackson is always a threat to penetrate, and he dishes off well, averaging close to 5 assists a game. Does a little bit of everything for the Buckeyes.
Part of the depth, and one of the reasons why you have to like this Buckeye team, now steps up to that free throw line. 7-foot center Bill Robinson out of Canton, Ohio.
When you go to the bench, a lot of times, you know, it's oversimplification, but it's true. Right? You either get better, you get worse. Most clubs, when they go to the bench, get a little worse. That's not the case here. Ohio State, especially bringing in Chris Jen, who was a starter earlier, they tend to get really emotional. That's why everybody loves Jen. He comes in, he fires everybody up.
Now, that was Cornelius McInerney, number 35, checking in for Purdue, and Standback sits down. Standback, a freshman, he was quiet in the opening minutes of this game. Not really much of a factor. Ball in Oliver's hands. Boilermakers are down by 3 with 12:46 to go in the first half. Oliver missing, Robinson rebounded. Lead pass, Boilermakers get back. Brown's 3, misfired. Loose on the floor, out of bounds. And they have ruled that it still belongs to Purdue. I'm not sure about that one. Well, I don't think I'd want to.
He's something, I'll tell you. I think he might be Italian, I'll tell you. He's got more. Look at him. He is coaching his brains out.
I think he's also officiating.
Oh.
I'm not going to make that call the other way in front of him right now. I'll tell you that. He's a football player, folks.
He's been angry since he got off the bus, Brent, I'll tell you.
He went to camp with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Chuck Noll could use that temperament right now. Boilermakers come down on the attack for Katie. Dump in, triple team down low, so they work the inside-outside game, but it doesn't fall for him.
That's the game you got to get going if you hope to win.
Need some rebounding, too. Jen's off the bench with a 3.
It's the man.
And Burr is over on Gene Katie with a technical foul. And at first he calls a timeout. No technical. Check that. No technical. He gave him the timeout. We'll be right back. Two-time high school basketball player of the year out of Springfield, Ohio. Ran the airs, then went to Miami of Ohio. And, Jimmy, why did Katie call that timeout there?
Gene knows that the margin of error is so slim in this game. He waited for it. A lot of people say, why did he wait for the TV timeout? If he waited and just another hoop or two, they'd have been out of the game. It was a good timeout, a smart timeout.
Pushing foul, the call against Ohio State. Baker's first personal of the game. There's Randy Ayers at 34, the youngest coach of the Big Ten.
I am amazed at his poise. I mean, it's really remarkable. I mean, he's 17-1, and third in the country. He's so relaxed on the bench.
He can walk through a shower and never get wet.
Well, they love him here, huh? Do they love him here?
You bet. They're wondering if he can coach football. All right, Boilermakers. Tough times for John Cooper. We'll try to bring the Buckeye football fortunes back next fall. Barrett dumps it on the inside. The white muscling.
Good call.
Next Saturday on ABC, the bowling tour moves on down to Florida. It'll be the $130,000 Florida Open on Saturday, and then following that, it'll be ABC's Wide World of Sports. Something rather interesting here, the world's fastest athlete will be a baseball player, Ricky Henderson. How about a pro football player, Eric Dickerson? Or how about one of the track and field stars? Then the Don Handicap for the older horses, older than 3 years old. And the Eclipse Awards. We'll find out who will be the horse of the year, the jockey of the year. That's all coming up next Saturday on ABC. Here it is, Jen for Ohio State, muscling in for his second field goal. Instant firepower off the bench. Give him a nickname.
I've got it. I looked it up. He's from Sparta, New Jersey. So he's got a guy off the bench has to have a nickname. His name should be Spartacris. You get that?
I got it.
Are the guys out there, does everybody understand Spartacus? They know that? Okay.
We got it. Okay.
Great nicknames. Off the bench, Spartacris.
The John Havlicek Award.
That's it.
Works it outside now. Boilermakers in need of a field goal. They trail it by 8. This is the most they've been down in this game. There were 15-point dogs coming in. Oliver and his third field goal. 2 threes and a deuce.
And that was not a mistake. He is a bank shark shot artist. He loves to bank the ball. A la Sam Jones. Well, he's the only guy doing anything right now for him.
Purdue has to feel awfully good about getting Oliver back into the offensive flow. Back away from the ball. There's a foul against Purdue. Technical on Gene Katie. Here it is. Here we go. Showtime. That, folks, was a lock.
That one, he's been trying to get that one, I said, since the training meal, I think. Now, the unfortunate thing is it may have taken him out of the game. I mean, we're talking at the 10-minute mark now. They're down by 8, a bucket here. It's going to be awful hard for them to come back.
Jim Burrow will give you that thing. He's not one to mess with. You can ask the general down there in Bloomington. He's had a few called on him. 2012, Ohio State now starting to exert itself. They won 17 in a row before losing to Michigan State. Now they're trying to step back up. And a foul goes against Purdue again. Dave Barrett, remember when you reach 10, you shoot 2 now the rest of the way. That's 5 team fouls already.
A very difficult team to defend, Ohio State. They've always got Jackson to get penetration when anything else breaks down. They shoot it outside. This guy coming in, Trent Lee, has been just shooting the ball so well. They've got it inside, outside, great balance. All 5 guys average double figures.
9:50 to go here in the first half. 2012, Ohio State with the lead. That's Jackson. Wanted Carter on the inside. Craig Riley, the 6'9 junior center out of Fort Wayne, Indiana, did a good job defensively, stepping around the man to help out on the inside.
Jamal Brown's been free. If he gets it to him, he's been free last couple of times down.
Rattles out. Purdue ball. He's got to find somebody else besides Oliver to go along with the scoring here for the Boilermakers. He has 8 of their 12 points in this game. Stand back. Oliver looking again, and Gent came out hard on him defensively. Oliver from behind Riley, and now it's 10 of 14 points.
Boy, that drive you nuts, coach.
Jackson, no, won't count, will not count. Foul was before the shot. Well, Randy Ayers said that this technical against Michigan State is what took the Buckeyes out of that game, so he knows all about a technical foul. He thought that his defensive player had position. They called a blocking foul, and there he is, giving the premier choke sign.
No, no, he was fixing his tie. That's all we coaches do. He was just trying to fix it a little bit. Look how composed he is.
Well, he also showed a lot of class during the week. He stepped up and he said that was a 7-point play. I turned the game around. I cost my team the game. That reminds me of how Bear Bryant, players never lost. It was always the bad coaching that went on down there. Obviously, they didn't play well, but Randy Ayers showing some maturity as a head coach after the fact. Now, the lead into Trice's hands. Riley. Up with a jump shot, missed everything. And now it's Baker. Penetrating move, missed field goal. Boilermakers back down. Here's Trice again. Trice pulls it back out. 23-14. Purdue with the ball and trailing.
They've got to take the outside shot. They got to pass it inside, kick it out. They must take the shot.
Brown's gamble cost him the second personal foul. So with Jim Valvano, I'm Brett Musburger. Doubleheader day here on ABC, because coming up next, the running Rebs against Rutgers. That's Jimmy V's alma mater. Or some of you will see down in the southeast, Georgia against Kentucky. Write it down, folks. UNLV is going unbeaten this season. Mark it down.
Not even at Arkansas. The Razorbacks are not going to get them, huh?
They will have a tougher game down there than they will when the tournament starts. stay out of their region. They are loaded. It's a better team than won the championship a year ago. Foul again.
You know, sometimes people think it's if you lose one, it's better. It takes the pressure off you. I was talking with Tark last week. We're having dinner, and I mentioned that to him, and he said, we want to win them all. They are, in coaching terminology, focused.
Purdue looking for a score to join Oliver. It's 23-14 inside the 8-minute mark here in Columbus, Ohio.
What Jen's trying to do is pick Oliver up a little bit higher. Another turnover. They got the numbers.
Baker gets it back to Brown. Missed the layup, and Gent is right there. Look at Gent bound onto the glass. And quickly the trap in the corner.
In the corner. Get it out of the corner.
They tie it up. And that ball belongs to Gent and the Buckeyes. John, thank you very much, and that probably rekindles DePaul's hopes for a spot in the NCAA tournament. Big win over Georgetown for Joey Meyer and the Blue Demons. Here it's Ohio State, coached by Randy Ayers, leading the Boilermakers of Purdue 25-14. How do they come back here?
I really believe that Purdue has to do two things. Number one, throw the ball over the top against the press and go to score. And number two, take three-point shots. Now, they've taken more three-pointers this year than they did all last year. So it can happen.
Gent missing the three.
Saying they got to get it up and take the shot when it's there. You're down by 11.
Now, let's see if they take as much time off the shot clock when they're down 11 as they have when the game was closer in the early stages of this contest. Pretty good defense by the Buckeyes, isn't it?
Outstanding half-court defense. Pressure on the ball is exceptional.
Look where they have got the offense. Forced them way out.
If you're going to run the clock down, you have to penetrate. You have to get penetration.
Oh, he forced the turnover. Easy breakout. It's Lee.
Ball's in the corner again. When you are milking the clock, Brent, it's imperative you have someone who can take the ball to the basket. And that's the problem. Their guards can't do that. I think they might be better served by playing. Getting it inside, kicking it outside, take the shot. There it is. Take it.
He's got it.
3 points by number 30.
It's the only way. I think you can come back when you're struggling with the basketball. When you hold the ball, you've got a great point guard who can go by people, fine. But otherwise, you're going to have to take that inside-outside
game. Link Darner's three. He utilized that shot very well at home against the Iowa team, but the Hawkeyes still won the game.
And lastly, I think they got to go to
see he's playing. What a game Craig Lee is having. 10 points here in the first half. Helping out defensively. Time remaining, it's 29-17. The Buckeyes have already scored 8 points off turnovers, and Purdue, zero off turnovers.
And they should have had another one that time. You've got to throw the ball. I think if you charted it, you'd see the ball go to the right corner almost every time against the press.
Foul is called. Let's check in with Mark Jones. Mark.
Ohio State won a Big Ten title. At the time, Jim Clemens and Luke Whitty were just some of the players on that team. At that time, Randy Ayers, the coach, was just a freshman in high school. But after speaking with some of the players this week, you get the feeling they will settle for nothing less than a Big Ten title this year. Guys?
All right, Mark, thank you very much. As Trice comes through with a driving layup.
So that's what he does, huh? Third and a half, he's got to get up top of the building.
That's why he disappears for a while. Of course, around here in Columbus, the ball club that everybody remembers is the Jerry Lucas team back in the early 60s. Wonderful college basketball team. They gave him, that's the secret to Craig Lee. Just let him shoot all alone and he might miss one.
Purdue, incidentally, Brent, has gone to a 2-3 zone to try and slow him down a little bit. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Well, it's amazing what a coaching change can do.
I knew that was coming.
You did. You could feel that.
There's two in a row now. And number three, Travis Trice, showing some moves on the inside out of Princeton, Indiana.
Now they've done two and three. They took the three-point shot inside out. They've gone to the basket. Now I want to see them score off the press. I want to throw it over the top and go, and they might be back in this thing.
Maybe the Boilermakers are finding a point man here this afternoon who can lead them back. Still trying to replace the departed Woody Austin. Good ball movement down on the inside. Score the field goal for Perry Carter.
Why that worked, Brent, was high-low against any zone, really any defense. If you can get the ball in the middle of the floor, you can get it in the middle of the floor right there. It's the middle of the floor, most dangerous place for a defense. You got a high-low, nice dish, Trent Lee doing everything. Carter up, get a chance for the three-point play. Excellent offensive execution against the zone.
You see any weakness with the Buckeyes?
Randy Ayers, last year we played them and we went out, and Randy is not a very good dancer. Last year we played them in a tournament in Charlotte, and that's the only weakness I see right now.
That's the only one you've seen. That's pretty good.
Hey, they're good. Brent, they really are a fine basketball team. Here comes the press. Throw it over the top. Right in here, you start over the top.
They take a lot of time, don't they, trying to get the ball in bounds?
Now go. Okay.
Up to stand back. Almost traveled. Oliver is 32, sends the bounce pass in on the inside, and Riley on the turnaround. Purdue has shot very well over the last minute and a half, and it's 32-23 as a result. But at the other end, they need some defensive stops here against this Buckeye team.
They stay in the zone. Ohio State does shoot the ball awfully good. It's tough to play zone. Chris Jen on the wing can stick it. All right, and we'll see the freshman, Skelton, if he can hit it over here. That's
he
what
traveled.
Freshmen do.
He traveled. Now the Boilermakers can put together a little bit of a run here. Get a spurt going, 32-23. 3.5 minutes to go. Skelton and the Buckeyes go over to the sideline. We've got a timeout in Columbus. We had a technical foul call on Gene Cady. And Jimmy V, what's been the scoring since then?
14-11 Ohio State, so it really wasn't that big a factor.
Now, Purdue has shot well from the floor, 10 of 16 for 62%, Ohio State 56%, but 8-3 rebounding edge for the Buckeyes here, and turnovers have plagued the Boilermakers. That's the storyline of our first half as we approach the three-minute mark. The Boilermakers looking for a little run here to climb back in it. Offensively, this is their most positive part of the game so far. And the ball is lost out of bounds. It's going to go over to the Buckeyes. I thought for a moment that Ohio State had handled it there at the end, but they did not.
But Purdue did a very good job, right? Link Darner that time drove to the basket, and they've got to have that penetration. Purdue stays in the zone. Look for Gent to get a shot.
Done a good job defensively here against Jackson in the first half, but Trey Lee has stepped up big time. Jackson over here in the corner, number 22. Now it's Carter. They drop back the double team. Jackson, an unselfish player. Gent off the fake. Beautiful jump pass. Wanted Carter on the inside.
Brent, what's so impressive is they're such a smart team. I said you could see Gent free, but he drove and then he got rid of it.
Jackson three. Purdue ball. So coming up at halftime now, John Saunders will be back in New York. Beth Ruyak will come along. She'll take a look at this Ohio State program under Randy Ayers. So that's all coming up. And college halftime, they'll also have the Foot Locker Slam Fest. And that's a show that Jim Valvano never misses.
Oh, don't. I thought you weren't going to mention it.
Barrett up on top. Stand back. Darner on the penetration draws the foul.
Link Darner, the son of a coach. See, that's why he's, you know, we always say, every time the guy's the son of a coach, you always say, and he's a smart player. Aren't there any fathers or coaches who weren't that great? You know, maybe he didn't teach them all that.
Any coaches have stupid sons?
That's what I'm saying. That's what I mean. I played for my dad. I don't remember anybody ever telling me when I played. He's the son of the coach. So he knows what he's doing.
How many times did you play on network television as a player?
On network television?
Yeah.
Never.
Never?
No.
Never once?
No, I played in high school when Marty Glickman did the game of the week.
Is that right?
That's about it.
Couldn't get the tap back at the Purdue end. Riley trying, then reaching back over the top. Had what appeared to be
easy putback, and we've got another jump ball situation, but it'll belong to Purdue out of bounds. Oliver's been quiet lately. And not now. He hits the three. They got him back. That's his third three here in the first half.
Can't let that happen. You've got to stay in touch with the one guy who can beat you. Shouldn't have even get a shot. That's a mistake in Ohio State. A mental letdown by my man Chris Chen. How could he do that?
Skelton missing the three off Lee's hand.
Good call.
And a push out against Lee on the foul goes over to Purdue. It's 32-26, and Gene Katie's team is hanging in the neighborhood here.
They have done an outstanding job coming back. The zone has slowed down Ohio State, got the tempo that Gene Katie wanted, and now if they can knock down two free throws, they're right back in it. You always like to be a bucket or two, either side, at halftime on the road. You still feel you got a shot at it.
Well, you play with the intensity and fire of a Gene Katie. You would never expect one of his teams to quit the way he drives them in practice session, and that certainly has been the case with Purdue through the years. This team not nearly as talented as some of his ball clubs have been recently. Riley knocks in the first one.
70% free throw shooter, so he should make them.
Something else happened with this crowd. When the Buckeyes assumed the lead, they quieted down a little bit, and they haven't climbed back in this game here for the last 5 or 6 minutes. This be a four-point game if he hits this free throw.
Purdue has also stopped the Ohio State transition game. And Purdue's on a 7-zip run right now, and Ohio State got no transition buckets.
So they were down 11. Riley's two free throws pull them back to within four now at the 140 mark in St. John Arena, trying to get back into it.
I think that the Ohio State should go high-low. Or hit a jumper at the top of the key, either one.
When you need one, go to number 22. 6 points of the first half. Turnover, here it is. Just when they get back in it, Jackson hits one. Then they get a turnover and a chance to do it again. And Jackson alertly brings it back out and calms everybody down. Lee inside, rattles in another one. He has been the high point man with 12 points for the Buckeyes.
That's what I was talking about, Brent. Against that zone, if you just put Lee high and keep anybody low, you're going to get a shot. And they did it that time at Penn with it, too.
The Buckeyes got four easily. For Purdue, it's hard work at the other end. Time remaining first half. Seconds ticking away. I think they'll try to find number 32. He's got the ball right now. That's Oliver.
Real dangerous part of the game here. They're going to try to hold it. If they aren't successful, watch Ohio State rush it down the court, maybe score, and then they get the first possession of the second half. This is a critical part of the game right here.
Trice to the glass. Missing. Ohio State ball as you predicted. Here the Buckeyes come now. Jackson knows it's last shot time.
Jackson will make the play.
Wants Jen in the corner, and they're going to take it back. Jen against the clock. Knocked free at the end of the half. 36-28, Ohio State. John Saunders and Beth Royak. We're coming up next on ABC.
Welcome back once again, everyone. I'm John Saunders. Joining me now is Beth Rujak with a look at the Ohio State Buckeyes. Very successful year, although it's been an up-and-down week.
John, this week the Buckeyes have been third place in the polls, but with some of the first-place votes that had until now unanimously gone to UNLV. Then Thursday came the loss at Michigan State, bringing the record down to 17-1. Still, Coach Ayers is taking nothing for granted.
See, we haven't been there yet. You look at the other teams in the top 10, and they've been there. And see, we've got a lot of things to accomplish before we can really sit back and enjoy it. I like this team because they understand that.
Columbus is crazy about its basketball Buckeyes. Perry Carter was given a cover shot and best body status. Coach Ayers receives loads of endorsement offers, though he is extremely selective and does only a few. Not since 1960 has a Buckeye team won the national championship, and although this team could snap that spell, Coach Ayers is focused on the Big Ten title.
If you go in our locker room, you'll see two things on there. players' lockers, and one that says Big Ten Champions 1971, and on the other side it'll say Big Ten Champions 19 and two slashes. And that's our goal.
Coming into this year, I think everybody worked especially hard on each individual game, and came out and worked pretty hard in practice. And, you know, we're putting it together now, and we're not overly, surprised, but we're happy.
A few weeks ago, news came regarding Columbus sensation Lawrence Funderburk. In 1989, as a freshman, Funderburk played six games for Indiana, fought with Coach Knight, and quit. Now he's coming home. Funderburk wouldn't return any of our phone calls, although he is now taking his first semester of classes here on campus. He can't play with the team yet or receive an athletic scholarship. But a few weeks into next basketball season, after the fall semester has ended, Lawrence Funderburk will begin 3 years of eligibility with the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Now we've provided him with the opportunity. Now it's up to him to take advantage of that by doing the things that we asked him to do both on and off the court. Now, I think it's very simple. If he abides by what we want done in this program, he's welcome to be a part of it.
For this year, Coach Ayer's program is shooting for the Final Four, hoping to fill in a few numbers along the way.
Back in Columbus, Ohio, with Jim Valvano and Mark Jones, I'm Brent Musburger. The Buckeyes led it by 10 at one point. And as we start the second half, it's 36-28. And the key number from the first half was turnovers and points off those turnovers. Purdue turned it over 9 times, resulting in 10 Ohio State points. The Buckeyes turned it over 3 times, and Purdue was unable to convert on any of those 3 occasions. So protecting the ball and getting to the attack zone has to be the key for the Boilermakers.
Right. And right now, watch Ohio State. Sometimes at half to halftime, you have a set play, try and get it to a particular player. They went for a double screen to Jimmy Jackson.
And the Boilermakers were ready. They did not squeeze the trigger on an easy field goal attempt. Trey Glee had a big time first half with a dozen points. Jackson misses the first shot. White, who had 2 fouls in the first half, saw limited duty, yanks the rebound down, bad pass, turnover. There's number 10. So ABC's college basketball featuring Purdue versus Ohio State is being brought to you by intensive treatment from Head and Shoulders, tough on persistent dandruff without medicated hair, and by MCI, a phone company that listens. Again, our score 36-28, Buckeyes with the lead. Jackson again trying to force in that field goal, and there's a foul underneath against the Boilermakers.
Gene Katie was so disappointed when Trice threw that long pass. You're trying to hang on to the ball, milk the clock a little, and your freshman throws it out the door the first possession of the second half, and you're trying to come back.
Oliver, their leading scorer, picks up his first personal. He had 13 points. Jackson, he's the leading man for the Buckeyes this year, has scored now 7 points after that free throw.
Talked about it before, the Buckeyes have the balance. They've got the whole package. They got the inside game. They got the 3-point shooters, and they have the guy, the go-to guy, who when the clock's winding down can make something happen. They're a club that can go very far in the NCAA tournament this year.
And they have a coaching staff headed by Randy Ayers, a surprising choice. Prior to last season, he's done a splendid job with this team. They get back defensively, trying to force another turnover.
Wow, a freshman, it's hard. It's hard to play as a fresh. They were coming at him from all angles that time. He didn't know. I've been very lucky to get a turnover there.
So quickly, a change at the point as Dave Barrett checks back in and Trice sits down. And if you weren't with us in the first half, Mr. Katie has already picked up a technical.
That's right. And he was asking for one, Brad. I mean, he was so nice last night in practice, though. Remember, Tuss? He said he's fine. Everything's relaxed. But then in today's practice, hey, it was tough, they tell me.
And he'll be even hotter under the collar against Indiana and Bob Knight next Sunday. This is friendly. Boilermakers patiently working inside to Chucky White, coming through for the driving field goal. Down by 7. Now it'll be up to the Boilermaker defense. Jackson glides through it. Oh, like a knife coming through hot butter. Beautiful move by JJ. Another turnover. A little too slick with the ball. They fired out of bounds.
I promise I'll say it only one more time, and that's it. Where did that inbounds pass go?
Right to the wrong spot in the corner.
That's better. To the middle or over the top, you got to shot it. Right to the corner, it's a turnover every time.
And respect for Link Darner on the outside. He hit 1-3, number 30 did in the first half. Buckeyes aggressively now, chasing Purdue. Oliver is still perfect on the outside. That's number 4 and 16 points for Oliver.
Jimmy Jackson lost him on the screen.
Craig Lee, and it rattled out into the hands of White. Boilermakers again hanging tough here in this game. Katy is working that sideline. Foul against Ohio State.
Jimmy Jackson has that penetration move, a front change. Look at that. Glides away from the defender and an easy deuce. Purdue struggles to score, and Ohio State, boom, gets it quickly. There's a guy who can score pretty easy.
I'm Lawrence right. Funderburk. Please call Beth Ruyak when you get a chance. Ball goes out of bounds. Retaining possession. So Barrett out on top now.
Inside, outside.
It pounded in to White. Wouldn't stay down. Ohio State, you can just feel it, how the Buckeyes want an entirely different tempo. They want to get up and down the floor in this game. Offense. Offensive foul. He muscled his way free. Let's check in with Mark Jones. Mark.
Yeah, you're looking at Lawrence Funderburk. He was one of the top freshmen in the country last year at Indiana, has since transferred now to Ohio State, is paying his own way. He's working out. I spoke with him just a few moments ago. He's grown 2 inches, gained 25 pounds. So if you think Ohio State is good this year, wait till next year.
He'll be eligible next January, by the way, since transferred from Indiana. Think what the Hoosiers would be like next year if he had stayed with that young talented team of Bob Knights that we're going to be seeing next Sunday down at Bloomington. Great game a couple weeks ago against Ohio State in Bloomington. Buckeyes finally went in there and beat Indiana, but Indiana came rushing at the end. Here it's Purdue. Can't get the roll. Rebound Lee underneath. 39-33. Buckeyes lead it. And here's their whiz, Jackson. Rattled out. White's rebound. White. That time they did not hesitate. They went for the field goal.
And it's a 4-point game. You let them hang around too long. Ohio State's got to get back to running their offense.
Easy on the inside, but it wouldn't stay down for Jackson, and the foul against Purdue.
We talked about this before. Against their pressure, run transition and go score. And that time, Purdue did just that. A little hanging around on the rim there by White.
Which is legal this year to avoid an injury. One of the rules that they are using. That is the third personal on Barrett. Darner leaves the floor.
I think that what Purdue needs to do, Brent, I think Gene is out of the coach's box. He wanted a technical foul for the dunk after the foul call down here. But anyway, I think that from the bench, they're going to try to alter their alignment against the press, bring more people up to the basketball. You don't have to worry about it. When you don't make the free throw, you can't press.
So Painter, running Gene Katie's team right now, set the table for an easy field goal. A 3-point game. Ohio State cannot extend its lead. They were up by 10 points in the first half, and they've turned it over now. Purdue's ball on the traveling call.
And Purdue is altering its alignment here, try and bring some more people up to the basketball. They're running to the ball. Randy Ayers needs to settle his club down, Brent. They're not running any offense. They're coming down and just going one-on-one right now. Over the top. Thank you. It didn't take too long.
Here is Oliver. White's jump pass on the inside. So number 34, Ian Stanback, the freshman from East St. Louis,
with his second field goal of his half. Total of 6 points now for the game. It's a one-point basketball game. The pound on the inside. Ohio State missing, and Purdue can take a lead. How about this?
Well, I tell you, Ohio State's been going awfully quick in their offensive sets. Had run a set play last five times down. They tried to score in transition.
Now Gene Katie really digging into this one. He's been coaching every trip here so far. His bench will explode if the Boilermakers can seize the lead.
All of a sudden, when you're the coach, Randy Ayers.
Inside pass, they've got it.
You say, I've never beaten this guy, Gene Katie. I might need a timeout here. He's never beaten him. And
18 points for Oliver. Is Purdue going to continue upset Sunday? We'll come back and find out. Time to live up to all the adjectives that people have been heaping on his shoulders. Jim Jackson only 3 of 10 here this afternoon. What can the Buckeyes do?
I look for two things. Number one, I think this time down they have to run their offense, get something off their offense. And then number two, I think Chris Chent needs to get in his ball game to get the Buckeyes moving again.
And the crowd awakening here in Columbus, Ohio. A 15-point favorite. Jackson from the perimeter. Missing again. He's 3 of 11. Contact underneath.
They did run their offense, and they ran it. They turned it over one side to the other and got a good shot. But as you said, one of the weaknesses in Jimmy Jackson's game, Brent, is the perimeter shot. He's better driving to the basket.
Now for Ayers, a foul problem. Carter will sit down with three personals. His last field goal at the 18:38 mark. We're 14:49. Purdue has hit 6 of 8 this half. They are on a 13-4 tear here in the second half in Columbus. Purdue 41, Ohio State 40. Another turnover, the difference in the first half. Brown steals it and rams it way up. Another ball knocked free, but into the hands of White. Protecting the ball will be critical for Purdue the rest of the way. Again from behind, but could knock it out of Oliver's hands.
Key mismatch, I think, right here is Leon Oliver. Oliver's got more speed and quickness.
To White, and he was fouled by number 54, Bill Robinson. Katie will bring Travis Trice off his bench.
Purdue's done one thing extremely well the last two or three times against the press. They altered their alignment, and then they threw it over the top, and then they've gone to score, which is good. But if this matchup of Treg Lee stays on Oliver, I'm telling you, Oliver's a little too quick for him. He can get his shot and go by him.
Link Darner replaces Painter for the Boilermakers, so two new guards check in for Gene Katie right now. The game at the 13:59 mark, and here, as you predicted, is the return of Gent.
And a good move, and I think it matchups much better right now. Not only is he, I think, get some juice for their ball club, but I also think the matchup on Oliver is going to be better now. Gent will probably move to him.
Gent, Robinson, and Brown on the floor, and Baker in the backcourt.
A little press from the Boilermakers here.
Darner and Trice set a press against them. Trying to get Brown. They did not show the press against that unit in the first half, but Katie counters with it here in the second half. And Riley will check into the game, and now White will get a breather. He played very well. Tie game. They were down by 10 in the first half. Jackson. Starting to find a touch with that one.
That one dribble gets him just a little closer, and that's a better range for him. But you push him out, Jimmy Jackson struggles a little bit.
Looking for the tying field goal. Oliver, he's their go-to guy with 18 points, number 32. They'll try to get it to him. He's got it out on top. Maneuvers for the jump shot. Ohio State. Baker out on the move. He'll look for the easy layup. Short. Yanked away by Stanback, an aggressive freshman rebounder, twice down with the ball.
Stanback is the best rebounder on the Purdue basketball team, and he went and got that one.
The three, mark it down. Link Darner has put the Boilermakers up by one at the 12:45 mark, playing a whale of a game as an underdog. Jackson, offensive foul, Purdue ball. Things are going against the Buckeyes.
When Ohio State gets out of their offense, they've been getting a little trouble. And here's the situation. Once he takes it on his own, gets the call there. Let's see if the man was there. I think he had position there, Brent. He was set. It was a good call by the official.
Purdue against this full-court pressure defense, bringing it up. Boilermakers have hit 6 of 7 from three-point range in this game, led by Oliver, who's perfect on 4 attempts.
If this game stays the way it is, I think a turning point is going to be, can the guards of Purdue, can Trice handle the heat when you get down inside 5 minutes?
Working the weave, which they started the game with, White in the middle, off to the side. Buckeye ball, Jackson handling. Into the hands of Baker, the point man. Ship inside, going regularly now to Jackson, stepped out of bounds.
Going a little bit too much to Jackson. And haven't seen any high-low play, haven't gotten some other guys in the game, going to him almost every time down. And there he is.
No question. Boilermakers ball against that pressure defense, almost not free. Foul called against Ohio State. Against Jent. Not quite as calm as he was in the first half. So we're going to take a break at the 11:57 mark. Purdue leads it by a point. The two coaches and Jim Valvano, how can Ohio State re-seize the initiative in this one?
I really believe they got to get their veterans, and they have veterans, to settle down and run your offense on the half court. Run the things that you do in practice and get a bucket from your offense, not necessarily just from individual play.
Katie signaling he wanted some motion off of this offensive set. The Boilermakers patiently bringing seconds off the 45-second shot clock before they turn it loose. They lead it by a point, have possession knocked away from Trice. Chance now for Jackson and the Buckeyes. Bounce pass to the other side. Ohio State takes the lead. Skelton comes through off the Jackson pass. In the middle, loose ball, out of bounds, Buckeyes.
That's the problem, Brent. I mean, we talked about before, if the game is close, the freshman guards, Trice, Darner, guys who haven't had that kind of heat. They need the experience, but there's two turnovers, and it could cost them 4 points.
Dave Barrett checks back into the game, number 22. So he'll become the point man. Trice will sit down, and Oliver comes back in, and Riley will take a seat for Purdue.
Barrett's a senior. I know that Gene feels it's critical time. He's been through all this before. At least get the ball up the floor in scoring position.
Critical time for the Purdue basketball team this season. This is one that could turn this whole season around for them if they could stage an upset here against Ohio State. This would be a huge win for the Boilermakers. Keeping a chase for an NCAA tournament spot. Keeping the middle level in the Big Ten, not dropping to the second division. Give the youngsters a lot of confidence. White!
Oh, White again. You know, he's a strong inside player, and Gent got, unfortunately, tried to front him. An excellent entry pass.
Now the Buckeyes under fire again, coming off their only loss of the year at the hands of Michigan State. Took a 10-point lead on Purdue in the first half. And they have struggled here in the second half as Barrett commits the personal for Katie's Boilermakers. And substitutes again, Carter will check back in, and so will Brown. And a reminder of what's ahead of you. That is 4 personals on Barrett, with Robinson sitting down for the Bucks. Gent still on the floor, along with Brown and Baker. This is Brown, a two. is on the line, only at two. But that's all it needed to give Ohio State a one-point lead.
You've got to get players like that involved. Jamal Brown, that was a nice out-of-bounds play, a set play. He got the jump. Trice almost lost it again.
Pounding again on the inside to White. Didn't have a shot attempt. Lots of time on the clock, so they patiently bring it to the outside. Trice a little bit out of control.
Young man is really struggling.
It's tough without that experienced point guard. 1 point Ohio State lead. Jen missing the three. Trice rebounding. They do not look for the breakout. They look to take their time. 9.5 minutes approaching the 50s. Purdue wants this game in the 60s if they can keep it there.
One thing, Brent, that Purdue has done and done very well when they fell down by 10 points is they stayed within the framework of that man's game plan. Gene Cady said, we're going to play a particular way. When they got down by 10-11, they never varied from that. That helped them stay in this basketball game.
Key moment in the game. Treg Lee returns, and Gent goes out with three fouls. And that time off the bench, Gent was not able to contribute like he did in the first half. So they did a better job defensively against him. This whole game is turning around Purdue's tough defense. Brown on the inside, ball's batted free with a vengeance by White. What a great play that was, and here is Oliver. And again, doing exactly what their coach wants. What a disciplined team this is.
There's no question. You just have to watch them warm up and see how disciplined they are. When they take layups during warm-ups, they come out and step on the half-court line. Every player, they do it when the coach isn't there. And that's really remarkable.
If the young point men can hold up, they can get an upset here in this one. They're going to be under pressure. Oliver's got the jump shot. No question about him. That's 20 points for the game. He's 8 of 10 from the field this afternoon here in Columbus. Skelton down the baseline. Short. And there was contact underneath. Skelton picks up the personal. So tonight, get the real story of what went on at the Little Bighorn. Gary Cole stars as George Armstrong Custer. And Son of the Morning Star, that miniseries starting tonight at 9 Eastern.
I read the book, and looking forward to seeing that. Excellent book.
You ever been to the battlefield and outside of Hardin, Montana?
In Montana, no, but I know you live. It's hard by your property that you have about 2,000 acres.
It's also hard to see how he could get ambushed in that open field.
And I'll tell you another thing that's hard to believe, and that is the job Purdue has done here. I honestly thought they were going to be buried there for a while when they got down by 10, and it's a remarkable job, and it's going to test the poise of Ohio State's basketball team and also of its coaching staff. You know, sometimes it's harder when you're at home and things aren't going well. You get a little, the fans, it makes it a little tighter for you.
51-48 Purdue, and Ohio State with 18 fouls here in this half, and Purdue with only four.
And a real gamble there. Gene Cady went to his zone, and Jamal Brown got the shot, and it paid off. The zone's going to give the three-pointer. A change of defense. They'll milk the clock now with the lead.
Now, the Buckeyes are going to start to feel the pressure here. How's that going to affect
this game? That's exactly what happens. Oh. Another mistake by Travis Trice. This is what he did. Forget the fact that they lost the ball. You never try to dribble a loose ball. You always grab it first, get possession first. Big error by Trice. Tried to bounce it. Don't dribble a loose ball. Purdue still in the zone. Watch out for that three.
Ohio State only 2 of 9 today from three-point range. Purdue is 6 of 7. They want him to take this shot. That was a two. Yanked away and knocked out of bounds by Purdue. Buckeye ball.
If they're going to stay in the zone, I really think they got to look at that high-low where they were successful in the first half.
Has that man driven this team? 7:49 to go, a 15-point underdog. He got a lead by three. We'll be right back. Katie pulling hard for her husband and the Boilermakers here this afternoon in Columbus, Ohio. His defense has held Ohio State to 29% from the field in the second half.
Another good move by Gene Katie. He changed defenses off a timeout.
Carter foul on the inside.
That's right, Coach. He's great. Right then, I really believe that Randy Ayers at that timeout said, we got to go high-low. We've got to not just go to Jimmy Jackson. And what did Gene Katie do? He changed from the zone to a man-to-man. So when the ball did go down low, that had a nice double team. Good job, really, by both coaches there. I think Ohio State's got to get Carter and Lee back in the ball game. You got to get that inside-outside game cooking again, and each time down, I think you need to look at that high-low post.
Missed free throw by Carter. Now Boilermakers with a two-point lead in 7.5 minutes here in Columbus. This would be by far their biggest win of the season if they can pull off this upset. They would still have a strong chance to get into the NCAA tournament. Remember, Illinois ineligible this year. And they'd like to take about five teams from the Big Ten. So Purdue badly in need of a quality win here or at Indiana next Sunday.
You know, it's great by Gene Katie. I mean, Katie stays with Trice. Stays with him. Takes him out. Talks to him. Makes a correction. Puts him back in. Shows the confidence in the youngster. So I still believe that's going to be the key. Guard play down the last 3 or 4 minutes.
Another miss by the off guard and contact underneath after the rebound. So next, UNLV, unbeaten and a solid number one going up against Rutgers, and some of you down in the southeast are going to see a dandy. Georgia against Kentucky.
And the guy who's doing, in my opinion, the best coaching job in America right there, Rick Pitino. What a job he's done. He used that three-point shot. Are they excited?
And here, they are uneasy. The heavily favored Buckeyes are down by two and looking for the tying trip. Inside to Carter, gets white in the air. Wouldn't stay down. Boilermakers giving him one shot, coming down with that rebound.
Right move. Made the right move. Set play. Get it down low. Now can they handle the pressure?
Darner, number 30, working with Trice. Two freshman guards, a freshman forward, White and Oliver, the experience on the inside. Oliver's been the go-to guy here today. He handles the ball for the first time in this set. He's number 32 now. Left-hand side of your screen. He's down low, twice far right. Now Oliver comes over, demands the ball. Steps out of bounds.
See, the problem, Brent, that Purdue has is as the clock winds down, you need penetration, and they don't get that. And so they go down low. We get a stepping out of bounds call right there with a little help, I think, from the defender.
At the other end, Jackson continues to struggle. He's only 4 of 13 against Purdue, handling the ball, maneuvering on the inside, and gets that one to fall. Now he's 5 of 14. Came at the right time. Tied the game at 51. 5:47. Off to Oliver, and the two of them will go in low. Trice out on top. Baker trying to pick his pocket.
As the clock winds down, you need someone to make the move to the basket, and generally speaking, it has to come from your backcourt. So I think Ohio State still has a big edge in this game the last 5 minutes.
Jackson trying to deny Oliver the ball. He comes out on top. They go in, and there's a pushing foul going against the Bucks.
Excellent execution. Ohio State really cannot allow Purdue to run the clock down and then dump a pass down inside. I think you need to front that guy down low and make the pass difficult for the point guard.
Gene Katie has the tempo he wanted in this game. Tied at 51 with 5 minutes to go.
They needed a game to be played in the 60s, and that's exactly where they are in this contest. In fact, he would have preferred it to be down to 40s.
He liked it to have been scoreless probably at the half, but he has accomplished what he set out to do. And Ohio State is in one of those games where, you know, at home you look back when the season's over. You know, one of those turning point games.
This could also be a turning point game for Indiana. They will play later today in the Big Ten. I'm sure that they have been watching this action and pulling hard for Purdue, because a win by the Boilermakers would give Indiana a chance to move into sole possession of first place. The winner of the Big Ten is going to wind up with a number one seed. That's almost a certainty. And thus they would avoid being in the same geographical bracket with Vegas in the tournament. That would be very important this year.
This play was called from the bench. From the bench. Randy Ayers,
Baker. Ties it up.
Gotta like that, Brent. Didn't go to Jackson.
And a violation, a five-second violation. Turnover. It's going to be the problem for Katie's team. So much inexperience there in the backcourt, trying to replace Woody Austin. Now a chance to go ahead. Offensive foul. It goes back to Purdue.
This is the shooter's touch, certainly, right up there for a while, and boom, goes down. That time, they ran the same exact play. Same exact play, Brent, and unfortunately, didn't get the job done, but excellent defense again. You know, Purdue plays both these clubs play excellent textbook man-to-man defense on a half court.
White and Oliver both in the backcourt. There's 10 fouls against Ohio State. Purdue shoots two the rest of the way.
Looked like they run in the belly series that time in football, Purdue. That pressure is going to really hurt them.
And they called a timeout. Katie obviously wanted the foul. Upset. Tell us what you really think, Gene. With 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go, Randy Ayers takes Jackson out of the game. Jackson and Baker on the sideline right now, tied at 53. Gent is in with Brown, Lee, Skelton, Carter.
I think the decision is a defensive one. Put your best defensive club on the court for a possession. See if you get a steal, get a turnover.
Boilermakers and the Buckeyes deadlocked at 53.
Good job front the post now. Ah, good job.
Let's check in with Mark Jones. Mark.
Guys, just picking up on what Jimmy was saying, that last time out, Randy Ayers ordered his Buckeyes to extend the defense. He wants them to deny on the wings a little more, hence it worked this time with a turnover. Back to you.
And Baker and Jackson return for the offensive set.
Excellent move, especially the fronting of the post as the clock winds down. That's important. Mentioned that before. It's going to be key in the last 4 minutes.
Jackson handling the ball. Back to Baker. This is Brown, number 30. Here's Jackson looking for the shot, and it rattled out. Foul against Purdue. Boilermakers were looking for the offensive charge, but it goes against the Boilermakers, and that ball was in the basket and rattled back out.
Jimmy Jackson, they brought him back in. They ran a 3-2 set, gave him a screen, and what he does so well, he penetrates well. He's also a 74% free throw shooter, and so that obviously very critical down the stretch in the close game.
Four personals on White.
I think we're going to look at Gent coming back in so they get to play the defense-offensive game here.
Here he comes.
Randy Ayers doing a nice job managing from the bench here, I tell you. Doing some nice things.
Putting a taller Gent over. Trying to check hard on Oliver, leading by two at the 3:48 mark.
Keys, don't foul. Don't be so aggressive that you give Purdue those two free shots.
There it is. Right by Skelton. And they have forced another turnover as Randy Ayers will call a timeout. He'll get Jackson back on the floor.
He'll call a timeout right now, so Randy Ayers pulling all the strings.
I love the arena. I just being in the arena. This is the first time I've been here at St. John. It's a special place. My alma mater goes the next one. You know, what they're doing in Vegas is they're running. It's a barbershop. They say, next. And this turn is Rutgers against Vegas. Then it's Georgia, Kentucky, the three-point haven down in Kentucky. Rick Pitino's got them jacking them up before ball over.
State 55, Purdue 53. With Jim Valvano and Mark Jones, I'm Brent Musburger. Nice to have you with us. We've got 3:33 to go.
And that man has done an outstanding job. Now, speaking of Randy Ayers, in game maintenance the last 2 minutes, utilizing the offense, the defense, and calling a timeout. Excellent job. Gene Cady goes to the zone. Could give up a three. I'd like to see a little high-low here.
Jackson goes cross-court.
There it is.
Want him on the inside.
I like it. Use that middle. Use that middle. Get it high.
The good ones always step up when they have to. 57-53 now. Two free throws and a field goal by Jackson. The difference. 3 minute mark. Purdue badly in need of a field goal on this trip. Darner being double teamed. Ball deflected. This is Barrett. By Jackson on this trip. This is Darner. Barrett tried to deny Oliver the three. Good hounding Ohio State defense this trip. Stolen. Three on one and a foul against Barrett.
Down the stretch, I knew pressure was going to be a problem, and there it was. Nice pick off the press. You can't go by people. You're going to have trouble late in the ball game. And there's Coach Cady working awful hard. I know how hard he's worked and how hard his team's worked. How disappointed he is, but you know they're going to play these last 2:27. It's not over. Awfully nice job down the stretch by 34-year-old Randy Ayers. What a future he has.
Barrett fouls out. Trice comes in for the last 2:27. Ohio State leading by four with Baker stepping up to the free throw line.
Very important right now for Ohio State. Don't think you have it won. Keep that same pressure. Sometimes there's a tendency to pull it off a little bit. Don't need to do that now.
Purdue has gone 2-43 without a point. And it's been the Ohio State defense that has shut down here in this game and proven to be the difference. Now trailing it by five. And it's Oliver rattled out, but a putback by Stanback, the freshman. He had position. They didn't block him out. They stay alive with that field goal.
What I'm saying is a tendency to relax a little bit. You got to keep doing what you did to get there.
Jackson handles it again. Number 22, Mr. Smooth, comes on the inside, hits another jump shot. He's taking charge. That's 20 points, and he's been especially effective down the stretch. To White, blocking foul against the Bucks. Carter was the defender.
You see the penetration that time, Brent? That time you see Travis Trice now, you know, penetrating, and that gives you an opportunity to get this foul. And since it's 10, you're going to get the two shots. Now, Jimmy Jackson, Brent, when he takes that ball on a dribble, you get him it's a pro play. You get him a screen, he can get just 3 or 4 feet closer. He's so much more effective than he has to take a downtown shot.
Jimmy, how long does it take a guard to learn how to handle college basketball and the frenzy and everything?
Unless you have those special skills coming out of high school, you know, you need 2 years of this kind of intensity before you'd have all the reads and you know exactly, you know, what you... The judgment. You need good judgment.
That time, they trapped Ohio State in the corner, but they come free. Jackson cuts for the blast. Got another one. Jimmy Jackson has taken over offensively. 62-57. A minute 25. A great effort here by Purdue, and it appears as though it's going to come up a little short.
I'll tell you, if I said it takes 2 years to be educated, he's done a whole semester here today. Tries 22 points off turnovers to Zippo for Purdue.
Jackson with 16 second half points. Oliver off the fake.
Heck of a player. He's a terrific player.
22 points for the Boilermakers. Final minute, 62-59. Brown through for the layup.
We need to score and use a timeout. Get a three-point shot up here.
Gonna need the three. White sends it back. Oliver to White. Buckeye ball, final 30 seconds. It was not easy. There's as much relief as there is joy here in Columbus.
A lot of tools. Ohio State's got a lot of tools. You come down the stretch, they utilize them. But we can't say enough about the job that Gene Cady has done. We already talked about Randy Ayers. Gene Cady has battled and fought, and he brought his team really to the brink of an upset, but just not quite enough.
A learning day for number three. 18 seconds now to go, 65-59, and Ohio State, after winning 17 in a row, beaten for the first time by Michigan State, will start another win streak here. And Indiana must win later today to keep up with them in the Big Ten. So Ohio State will come to that free throw line again with 10 seconds to go. Game of our doubleheader. You'll either see Rutgers against Las Vegas or Georgia, Kentucky from the Southeastern Conference. Jamie Skelton checks in the defensive unit, and remember, this is the five that turned it around. When they took Jackson and Baker out of the floor, this contingent forced a turnover. Then they brought Jackson back in the game. He got hot. Oliver misfires on the three. And it's over in Columbus. 66-59. Randy Ayers and Gene Cady
Katie fires one final salvo at the officials.
One more. He gave him a little point there. He's a tough man, I tell you. He has a heck of a basketball team.
66-59. So for Mark Jones and Jim Valvano, I'm Brent Musburger. Right now, let's send you along.